One of the reasons that Green Arrow is here is the proud heritage of Doncaster as a town, as an engineering centre and a railway hub. There is the name on the wonderful brass works plate on the side of the engine. But what of Doncaster? Let's go and talk to Laura from the collections team from the Danum Museum to find out a bit more. Laura, it's fantastic that the V2 is here in the museum in Doncaster, but Doncaster has a rich resonance with railways. Where does it start?
Well, the Doncaster Railway Works opened in 1853. It was never referred to as the Railway Works. It was always the plant or Doncaster plant. And it was hugely important for the local economy. When it first opened, the town's population expanded rapidly as people moved here for work. And at its height, there were over 4,000 people that worked at the plant, and it covered about 200 acres. So it's hugely important as a local industry. And of course, it still is today through companies like Hitachi that are based in Doncaster.
Right, so there is a legacy now. It's not one of these industries that's gone and passed away.
No, obviously the plant as it was has changed, but we've got companies like Wabtec and Hitachi that still employ large numbers of people in the town, in the city, I should say now.
It wasn't just South Yorkshire and Doncaster that built these locos though, was it? South Yorkshire powered them too.
That's right. The steam locomotives that were built in Doncaster were built specifically to be fired by the type of coal that was mined in South Yorkshire, which was bitumen coal. So you've got these two major industries in Doncaster, the mines and the railways, that are working together.
And they're working side by side
to keep
the wheels of industry
turning.
Right,
yes.
And which we've seen in this engine with its very wide firebox designed specifically to burn that coal.
Yes.
Fantastic. So Green Arrow is very, very proud here. It stands wonderfully. It's illuminated greatly. It almost feels that we're in somewhere that's a form of reverence. What does it mean for Doncaster to have the engine here?
We get so many people that come into this building and say, I used to work at the plant, my father or grandfather worked at the plant. I remember this piece of equipment from when I worked at the plant, and my grandfather drove Flying Scotsman. So there's this real connection with the railways in Doncaster still. And I think people regard Green Arrow and the other Doncaster built locomotive that we've got as having come home, because obviously this is where they were built. And the fact that Doncaster produced such famous locomotives like Flying Scotsman and Mallard, I think there's a real pride around that. And just 200 metres from here, we've got Sir Nigel Gresley Square. So that legacy still continues in Doncaster.
So the engine's here in this wonderful purpose-built gallery, and we're surrounded by all sorts of other railway relics, aren't we?
Yes, that's right. In the 1940s, Doncaster Grammar School formed a railway society, and this was at a time when the railways were moving from steam locomotives to diesel locomotives, so they started to collect objects that reflected that history before they all became obsolete, and that's what we've got here. We've got railway signs and nameplates and all sorts of other equipment, signalling equipment and so on. They couldn't collect a locomotive, unfortunately. I'm sure they would have done if they'd been able to, but we've got all these on display now here at the Danum Gallery.
Yeah, well, what a fantastic legacy, and I can see that the team are going to have a real trouble getting me out at the end of filming today. But thanks very much,
okay,
Laura.
No
That's
problem.
Really appreciative.
Thank you.
Thank you.